Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission System. And this is lecture number 5.2. We continue from the earlier lecture on the fundamentals of gear drive. So, in this lecture also, we are going to continue with the fundamentals of gear drive. And in the earlier lecture, we defined the gear drive and we classified, we have seen different types of gear drive, law of gearing and the types of gear profile. And here, we'll be discussing on the pressure angle, gear nomenclature, the backlash, conjugate action, interference and undercutting in the gear drive. The learning outcome to this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define pressure angle and its significance, define various parameters of the gear drive, and define the interference and the undercutting. So, look at the diagram. So, the pressure angle is mentioned here. Phi is the pressure angle. And how the pressure angle is measured? So, we draw a tangent. So, the blue color line. So, this is larger wheel is gear and the smaller wheel is the pinion, the center of the pinion and center of the gear. And this is the pitch circle of the gear and here we have the pitch circle of the pinion. Now, the point of contact, we draw a tangent to the pitch circle. So, this is the tangent, this is the point of contact. So, this is the center point and this is the point of contact. Now, we draw a vertical line. This red color line is line of action. It is common normal red color line, which is point meeting point of the gear tooth here. We draw a center line. The angle between the line of action and the center line is the pressure angle. So, we have different terminology, angle of access, angle of approach, and beginning, this is the, when the gear wheel is rotating, this is the beginning of contact and this is the end of the contact, leaving the contact. So, the wheel is rotating in the circular clockwise direction, here it is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction and this is the beginning of contact and this is the end of the contact. So, the angle here, it is measured as pressure angle phi. If the tangent is drawn to the invalid profile of a tooth at any point on the curve and if a radial line is drawn through this point of tangency, the connecting this point with the center of the gear, then the acute angle included between this tangent and the radial is defined as the pressure angle. So, the tangent and the radial line, this angle is called as, the acute angle is called as pressure angle. And the IS 2535, it gives 14.5, 15 degree, 20 degree, 25 degree, and 30 degree. These are all the different pressure angle used in the gear design as per the specification. But normally we will be using 14.5, 14.5 or 15 degree to some extent, some cases 20 degree gear design. So, the pressure angle, it will be specified in the problem, otherwise we have to assume suitably the pressure angle. The effect of increasing the pressure angle. So, the limiting number of teeth to avoid undercutting is lowered. So, when you increase the pressure angle, that is, the pinion may have less number of teeth without undercutting. So, when you increase the pressure angle, the effect of undercutting will be lowered. The shape of the tooth become more pointed or peaked. So, when you increase the pressure angle, the peak point, the profile of the gear tooth will become pointed. Tooth flank becomes more curved. The relative sliding velocity is reduced. The contact ratio and the overlap are reduced. The tooth pressure and the axle pressure increases. So, these are all the effect of increasing the pressure angle. And this is how the gear pair, the pinion and the gear, they engage and start of contact and end of leaving the contact. So, you assume this is the top wheel is the gear and the bottom wheel is the pinion. And we have the pitch, so red color dotted line is the pitch circle of the gear and the pitch circle of the pinion. and we draw a tangent to the pitch circle. These two tangent, it is a common tangent between the gear and the pinion. That is a requirement. It should be a common tangent. And look at the contact. So we have a point contact. So the contact of the gear and the pinion should be point and it is moving. So this is the spur gear. So the effect of pressure angle, when you change the pressure angle, so the type of tooth profile will change and the load carrying capacity of the profile also changing, the stress on the tooth also changing. So this is the requirement. So the point contact and the common tangent between the gear and the pinion and the point of contact, they are the requirement of the gear drive. And we discuss the gear nomenclature. So there are different parameters in the gear profile. So top land, circular pitch, tooth thickness, width of the space, addendum circle, addendum, dedendum, working depth, everything we see one by one. So first the circular pitch circle. So pitch circle, so this circle is called as pitch circle. Pitch circle, top circle, that is outer circle and the base circle. So this base circle, this is the base circle and this is the top circle, tip circle, base circle and the pitch circle. So theoretical circle upon which all the calculations are based. Pitch circle is the reference point. So for all our calculation we are using the pitch circle. The pitch circle of a pair of mating gears are tangent to each other. That is the requirement. The pitch circle tangent, there should be a common tangent between the mating gears. That is the pitch circle. Then circular pitch. So look at the here diagram once again. Circular pitch is the distance from the point here up to this point. So in the adjacent gear. So you start from the point and adjacent gear, the same point, the length is called as circular pitch. Circular pitch is the distance measured in the pitch circle from point of one tooth to the corresponding point on the adjacent tooth. It is a sum of tooth thickness and width of the space. So the thickness, so this is called as tooth thickness and this space is called as width of the space. So the sum of tooth thickness and the width of the space is called as circular pitch. And addendum. So we have a pitch circle, PCD, pitch circle diameter and the tip circle diameter. The addendum is the radial distance between the top land and the pitch circle. So this is called as top land. So the height is called as addendum. And dedendum is the radial distance between the bottom land and the pitch circle. So we have the bottom land. This is the root circle of the gear. This is the tip circle of the gear. The height between the pitch circle and the root circle is called as dedendum. And we define the module. So module is important parameter. The module of the two gears, mating gears, should be the same. Module is the ratio of pitch diameter to the number of teeth. So module M equal to pi d by capital N. N is the number of teeth. And the depth is called as depth is the sum of the addendum and the dedendum. Depth of the gear tooth is the sum of addendum and the dedendum. And the clearance is the amount by which the dedendum is given. Given gear exceeds the addendum of the mating gear. That is what clearance. The amount by which the dedendum in a given gear exceeds the addendum of the mating gear. And the backlash is the amount by which the width of the tooth space exceeds the thickness of engaging tooth measured on the pitch circle. So backlash is the amount by which the width of the tooth space exceeds the thickness of the engaging tooth measured in the pitch circle is the backlash. And the thickness of the tooth. So thickness of the tooth is the thickness measured along the pitch circle. So this is the thickness of the tooth. And we have the face of the tooth. So this is called as the face of the tooth. So above the pitch circle diameter, we have the face. So face of the tooth is the surface of the tooth between the tip circle and the pitch circle, tip cylinder and the pitch cylinder. That is tip circle diameter and the pitch circle diameter. So this is the face. And the flank, so the bottom surface. The flank is the flank of the tooth is the surface of the tooth between the root cylinder and the pitch cylinder. So the root circle diameter or base circle diameter and the pitch circle diameter, this is called as flank. And we have the face width. Face width of the gear is measured parallel to the axis. So this length is called as width of the gear. So that is called as face width of the gear, which is measured parallel to the axis. And the type of the gear tooth. So full depth 20 degree involute system, full depth 14.5 degree involute system, full depth 15 degree involute system, and the stub teeth. So there are different types of teeth, tooth profile we are using in our design. So you look at here, majority of the tooth profile, they are involute. So we are designing only with the involute profile. And these are all the full depth gear, 14.5 degree, 20 degree and 25 degree, and these are all the stub tooth gear. So unless it is mentioned in the problem, normally we use the full depth gear with 14.5 or 20 degree the pressure angle. And backlash can be defined as the play between mating pair of gear teeth in assembled condition. It is a play, it is a clearance, small space. It is the amount by which the width of the tooth space exceeds the thickness of the meshing tooth measured on the pitch circle. So backlash is important parameter for smooth running of the gear. So this is the module and the corresponding backlash. When the pitch line velocity is up to 8 meters per second, above 8 meters per second, so the backlash should be within this minimum and maximum value for the given module. So this is a design parameter which we will be using for our design calculation. And the conjugate profile. So the conjugate action, conjugate profile, it is important for the spur gear design with the involute profile. To obtain the expected velocity ratio of the tooth profile, the normal line of the their profile must pass through the corresponding pitch point, which is decided by the velocity ratio. The two profile which satisfy this requirement are called as conjugate profile. So the normal tangent to the pitch PCD of the two pair, it is very important, that defines the velocity ratio, that defines the conjugate profile. And conjugate action, it is essential for correctly meshing the gear. The size of the teeth, that is the module define the size of the teeth, must be the same for the gear. The module should be the same for the both the gear, that means size of the teeth should be the same for both the gear. Another requirement, the shape of the teeth necessary for the speed ratio to remain constant during the increment of rotation, this behavior of contacting surfaces is known as conjugate action. So when we said beginning of the contact, leaving contact, between the beginning and leaving contact, the gear ratio should be the same. So that kind of action is called as conjugate action. Interference and undercutting. Involute profile begin at the base circle and extends outward to form gear tooth profile. There is no involute outside the base circle. The line of action of the two intermeshing gears is tangent to the two base circle. The two point of tangency represent the two extreme limiting point of the length of action. The mating tooth profile of the gear pair must consist of involute curve to have maintained the conjugate action. The portion of the tooth profile which lies between the base circle and the root circle comprises non-involute curve. Any meshing outside the non-involute portion will result non-conjugate action. So the meshing should be within the involute of the curve. The contact outside the involute profile is called as interference. So the condition for the gear engagement is within the involute profile, the gear should engage. So if the gear engage outside the involute profile, that is called as interference, and the interference will weaken the teeth, because the force will be acting on the non-involute area, so that will weaken the gear teeth. So during the gear cutting, the removal of material at the root of the gear tooth is called as undercutting. So the gear manufacturing operation, removal of material root of the gear is called as undercutting. So this is what the undercutting. So the look at here, this is the pinion and the gear, and it is called as undercutting, and this gap is called as interference. So starting point, so it is starting, so it is actually the two gears, they are making contact only within the involute profile. That is very important for the gear engagement and the during the transmission of the power. Method of eliminating gear tooth interference. In certain spur gear design, If interference exists, it can be overcome by removing the cross-hatched tooth tips, that is using stub teeth. When you have interference, you can use the stub teeth. Increasing number of teeth on the mating pinion, so increasing the pressure angle. Tooth profile modification or profile shifting, so increasing the center distance. So these are all the methods methods to overcome the interference in the spur gear design. And minimum number of teeth on the pinion to avoid interference is given for a given gear. So Z1 equal to 2 by sin square phi. So the phi is the pressure angle, and the Z1 is normally 31.9, that is 32 for 14.5 degree pressure angle, and Z1 is 17 for 20 degree pressure angle, and Z1 is 14 for 22.5 degree pressure angle. So when you increase the, look at the calculation, when you increase the pressure angle, the number of teeth is decreasing. That is the effect of the pressure angle, increasing the pressure angle. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject. You may refer to it, and I upload the video lectures on the subjects mentioned here in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture in the subject design of transmission system.